Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest, inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren.
And I'm Dale.
And in this video, we're going to talk about ROI and payback for solar energy systems in 2023. So Dale, as our president and CEO, I thought you would be best suited for discussing this topic since you look at business investments on a regular basis. Talk to us a little bit, Dale, about what the ROI and payback look like for both residential and commercial solar systems right now.
Yeah, so let's start with residential, maybe the easier one. ROIs are typically running in the 6 to 8% range, I would say, and you're looking at a payback that's somewhere between 12 and maybe 18 years, depending on production of the system and so forth. On commercial, commercial is where we could really see some changes in the future, but commercial right now, you're probably looking at the 6 to 10 year range, depending on the system, and for the payback, and your ROI is probably running in the 10 to 15% range. We see some higher than that.
But. And where do you see that going into next year?
That's a really wild card because 1/1/2023, the Inflation Reduction Act kicks in. The new incentives. So we're starting with a 30% tax credit, excuse me, and that's a great place to start. We've been at 26%, so we're at 30. And from there, there's 10% adders. And those 10% adders could have dramatic impacts on payback because not only could they take it from 30 to 40 to 50 to 60, but it's all on the front end.
Right.
So you're getting phenomenal paybacks in year one. One of the beauties of solar is that the ROI, the return on your investment, is not linear. It's front loaded, and we've seen customers sometimes get paybacks if they have a grant of some sort of a year,
sure,
you know, or just over that. So the paybacks are gonna get better in 2023.
Yeah. And then when you're looking at, as a business owner, comparing your investing in solar versus investing in another piece of equipment, how would you go about looking at those different comparisons, either another piece of equipment, or how would you compare that to another investment on the personal side, maybe for residential, to a mutual fund or an IRA investment?
Yeah, so we'll start with residential again. I think one thing to keep in mind is that it is a cost reduction.
Sure.
So you're going to save money. And in the residential side, that is basically a tax-exempt savings. If you're in a mutual fund, an IRA could be tax-deferred, but a regular investment of some sort, you're probably going to pay taxes on the income. So in this case, you've got a tax-deferred investment, and I don't know what your experience has been, but my experience in the past year is that some of those are not paying very good returns right now.
Sure.
So they're certainly not guaranteed. And with a cost savings investment like solar, you basically lock in your investment return because if anything, it might go higher. We've all seen what's happening with electric rates right now, and it's been pretty crazy. So as they escalate, your savings go up, and it just is a great cash conserver. You know, we see people who are retirement age putting in solar because it's a great way to conserve cash for them for the next 20 years of living in that house. Let's talk about businesses a little bit different. You're talking about investing in a lot of times in growth for the company or new equipment. And in the new case of new equipment, you're talking about a very limited life. Solar has a long life. I mean, we know it's 30 years, and it could be longer. I mean, it's not like these panels are suddenly going to stop producing electricity.
Sure.
So we've got a long life on the system, and it's that front-loaded benefit that makes it different. It's not a linear return. It's not going to be X amount for the next 5 years or 10 years. It's going to be, you know, 50% or more in year one, and then it's going to gradually come back. So, and you know, those are numbers you have to run if you're a business, to run through the calculation and say, does it make sense? But, you know, when people build a building, they're doing it because they're tired of paying the rent.
Sure.
And having nothing to show for it. Electricity is the same way. We're just conditioned to pay utility companies for electricity indefinitely. And this is a case where you can get away from that. You can basically own your own building. You can own your own generating facility and have significant savings for the next 30 years.
So what would you say to somebody, Dale, who told you that solar is just too expensive?
It is pretty expensive.
Yeah.
I mean, the upfront costs are significant. But again, it's a numbers game.
Yeah.
You know, you got to run the numbers. And the reality is utility bills are too expensive too right now.
Yeah.
And they're getting more expensive. So you're going to pay, people don't put in their balance sheet a liability for utility for the next 20 years. But the reality is it's there.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're going to be in business, if you're going to be using electricity, you've got a commitment to the utility company that is indefinite.
Right.
And with solar, you can make a commitment to a bank. If you know, if you don't have the assets, you don't have the cash to put into it, you make a commitment to a bank, to a lending organization that might be 5 years, 10 years, whatever you need. And when that's finished, you have no commitment.
Right.
No commitment to the utility company, no commitment to the bank. It's yours.
What about timing? We often hear people say, this just isn't the right time to go solar.
Yeah, so you know, a lot of talk now about recession.
Yeah.
You know, is there a recession coming? I've always found that when you're entering into a downturn, recession, what you really want to do is control costs. You want to reduce your costs. Solar does that really, really well. So, you know, if you can get rid of your electric bill, you don't have to worry on your sales increasing to pay for this investment. All you have to do is get the system installed, and now you have this runway of not having to pay the utility company. Yeah. And anybody in a downturn that doesn't have to pay electric bill would be very pleased.
Sure. Thanks for watching. If you found this valuable and you'd like to find out more about how a solar investment would look for you, what the numbers would look like specifically for your business or your home, click on the link in the description below to request a quote.